स्टैंडर्ड 10th पॉलिटिकल साइंस लेसन नंबर 4 सोशल एंड पॉलिटिकल मूवमेंट्स वील सी द टेक्सचुअल क्वेश्चन आंसर मार्किंग्स ओपन योर टेक्स्ट बुक्स टू पेज नंबर 96 क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 चूज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन फ्रॉम द गिवन ऑप्शंस एंड कंप्लीट द सेंटेंसेस द फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट डैश इज द मेन डिमांड ऑफ फार्मर्स मूवमेंट द आंसर इज To get the right price for agricultural production. Second, to increase agricultural production and become self-sufficient with regard to food grains, dash was initiated. The answer is Green Revolution. Question number 2, write short notes on 2.1. The first one, tribal movement. The answer to this question is on page number 93. Right hand side, first paragraph, it's highlighted in blue. Tribal movement. First line, first point. In the pre-independence period, the British government deprived tribal people of their right to livelihood on forest resources. Second point, there was a tribal uprising in Kolam from Chota Nagpur, Gond from Orissa, Koli, Billa and Ramoshi from Maharashtra, Santhal and Munda from Bihar. Third point, the tribal struggle has continued since those years. Fourth, tribals in India face several problems. Fifth, one major problem is that they are denied right over forests. Sixth, the main demand of the tribal movement is to accept their right over forests. Seventh and the last point, they should be allowed to collect products of forest and also should have a right to cultivate on forest land. This is answer 2.1, which comprises of 7 points. Question number 2.2, workers movement. Now the question here is wrong. Cancel workers in place of that, write labor. Okay, so the short note is short note on labor movement. The answer to this question is on page 94, left hand side, below the yellow box. Trade unions, cancel that. In place of trade unions, write labor movement. First line, first paragraph. The same paragraph, first line is your first point. Trade union in India emerged in the background of industrialization. Second point, textile industry, railway companies were established in India in the latter half of the 19th century. Third, in 1899, railway workers went on strike for their demands. Fourth, however, the first organization for resolving the issues of workers was established in 1920. Cancel this organization is and continue with the point. Was established in 1920, known as All India Trade Union Congress. Fifth point, in the post-independence period, cancel trade unions in place of that, right, labor movement. In the post-independence period, labor movement started working more effectively. Sixth point, same page, see the right-hand side. At the top, first line, in 1960s and 1970s, cancel trade union and write labor. Labor movement organized several agitations. Seventh point, but from 1980s, trade union movement started getting disintegrated. Eighth, globalization has affected the trade union movement to a great extent. Ninth, in India, workers are facing different problems. Tenth, and the last point, unstable employment conditions, contract labor, financial insecurity, absence of legal protection for workers, unlimited working hours, insecurity at the workplace, health hazards are some of the problems. Still here, that's answer 2.2, which comprises of 10 points. Question number 2.3. Okay, there's no 2.3. We'll go to question number 3. Answer the following questions in brief. Question number 1, that's 3.1. Explain the activities, roles, functions of environmental movement. The answer to this is on page 95. Right hand side, first paragraph highlighted in blue. Environment movements. Second line is your first point. Environmental degradation is a serious problem at national and international level. At the international level, several movements are working to stop the deterioration of the environment. Third point, a significant international cooperation, after cooperation, right, can be observed in this field. Fourth point, in India, many movements are working on different aspects of environment. Fifth and the last point, the environment movements are taking up issues like protection of the biodiversity, protecting different sources of water, protection of forests, green belt, pollution of rivers, use of chemical and their ill effects, etc. That's answer 3.1, which comprises of 5 points. Next, question number 3.2, explain the nature of farmers' movement. The answer to this question is on page number 93. Right hand side, last paragraph, highlighted in blue, farmers' movement in India. First line, first point, farmers' movement in India is an important movement. Second point, during the British period, farmers started getting organized due to anti-agriculture policies of the British colonial government. Next line is a third point, but before farmers' movements, right, there were farmers' movements in Bardoli, Champaranya and movements against revenue collection. Fourth, the farmers' movements were inspired by the thoughts of Mahatma Phule, Justice Ranade and Mahatma Gandhi. Fifth, due to some reforms in agriculture, tenancy laws, laws relating to tilting of land, etc., the farmers' movement slowed down. Sixth, after the Green Revolution, the farmers' movement became more active and effective. Seventh, though Green Revolution aimed at increasing agricultural production and achieving self-sufficiency, next page, left-hand side, first line, in food grains, it did not benefit the poor farmers. Leave a line after that. See the next line, that's point number 8. Dissatisfaction among the poor farmers led to the beginning of farmers' movement. Ninth, appropriate price for agricultural products, agriculture to be treated as an industry, implementation of the recommendations of the Swaminathan Commission, debt relief, debt cancellation, national policy for agriculture are some of the demands of the farmers' movement. Tenth and the last point, Shetkari Sanghatana, Bharatiya Kisan Union, All India Kisan Sabha are some of the important farmers' organizations in India. Till here. That's answer 3.2, which comprises of 10 points. Next question, 3.3. For which reforms were the women's movement in the pre-independence period fighting? The answer to this question is on page 94. Right hand side. Women's movement, it's highlighted in blue. First line, first point. In the pre-independence period, progressive men in India initiated the women's movement. Second point, the women's movement aimed at eliminating injustice against women and ending their exploitation, helped them to lead a respectful life and participate actively in social life. Third point, Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Mahatma Jyotirao Phule, Savitribai Phule, Maharshi Dhondo Keshav Karve, Pandita Ramabai, Ramabai Ranade took initiative in ending the practice of sati and child marriages. Fourth and the last point, reforms such as widow remarriage, women education and right to vote to women were possible due to the work of these reformists. So this is answer 3.3, which comprises of 4 points. Next question, question number 4. Explain the following statements whether they are true or false by giving reasons. The first statement, that is number 4.1. Movements are important in a democracy. The answer to this statement is true and the reasons are on page number 91. left hand side, sorry, right hand side, it's highlighted in blue. Y movements. In that, see the second paragraph, first line. That's your first point. Movements are very important in a democracy. Second, different social problems come under discussion through these movements. Third, the government then has to pay attention to such problems. Fourth, leaders and activists of the movement provide necessary information about these issues to the government. Fifth, this information is very useful for the government while making policies. Sixth, such movements aim at opposing a particular decision or policy of the government. Seventh, the right to protest is considered an important right in democracy. Till here, that's answer 4.1, which comprises of 7 points. We'll see question number 4.2. Movements do not need a strong leadership. The statement is false. The reasons are on page number 92. Left hand side. What is a movement? In that, see the fourth point. There are bullets now here. We'll see the fourth one just above the yellow box. Left hand side. First point, movements have a leadership. Second, leadership keeps the movement active. Third, objectives of the movement, program of action, strategy of agitation are decided by its leaders. Fourth, a strong leadership makes movement effective. Till here, that's answer 4.2, 4 points. Next question number 4.3, that's the last question. 4.3. Consumer movement came into existence. This statement is true. The reasons are on page 95. Right hand side. Last paragraph. Consumer movement is highlighted in blue. First line, first point. Consumer movement emerged in India after the Consumer Protection Act came into existence in 1986. Second, this movement has a broad objective. Third, the movement believes that each member of the society is a consumer. Fourth, due to the changing nature of social and economic system, consumers face different problems. Fifth, adulteration, increased cost of items, fraud in weights and measures are some of the problems. Next page, page number 96, left hand side, first line, sixth point. The consumer movement works to protect consumers from such types of fraud. Till here, that's answer 4.3, which comprises of 6 points. So children, I want you all to copy down these answers in your history notebook. Thank you, boys.